your corporate church. The reason houses are attacked, people are abducted, is because there is a loophole in our land. If we merge the loopholes, they will come to your house, you will be sleeping, they will see you. Because the strength of one becomes the strength of all. They will look at you, people will be driving, they will see your car, and they will know why. The supernatural will become commonplace. Because the only way you can get one is when you get all. Because all of us have become a corporate persona in the spirit. The reason we are vulnerable is because we are divided. And Jesus said, wherever two or three are gathered together in my name. He wanted to give them the Holy Spirit. He said, tarry in Jerusalem. And the Bible said, they were together in one accord. So long as we are one, the day we divide, we become weak. That day you will hear of deaths. You will hear of rape. You will hear of abductions. The reason it looks as if we are weak is because we are divided. One man talking against another pastor. Another one talking against another church. When a brother falls, the only thing you owe him is prayer. Because the idea is not to weaken the army, the soldier that is wounded. The idea is to strengthen him and to raise him up. Because there is no testimony in the form of one. There is only a testimony in the lies. Because he said, when the righteous man falls seven times, he shall rise again. But we have a church where we are setting traps for ourselves. We are interested in people falling. And when somebody fails, you see 90,000 shares on the internet. Most of the people sharing it are Christian. Nobody goes on their knees and say, how can this one fall? Nobody, so we are divided. And so long as we are divided, we are weak. That's why the terror continues to grow. But today, God wants to do a mending work. That the church will come together again in unity. Oh, in Psalm 133 from verse 1 to 3, he said, behold, how beautiful and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in harmony. He said, it's like the ointment on the head of Aaron that runs down his beard, even onto his skirt. He said, it's like the dew upon Mount Hermon. Dear, the Lord commanded his blessing. The power of the anointing cannot be seen in the territory until the church is one. The reason what happens on the head of Aaron will happen on his skirt is because brethren dwell together in harmony. If we don't know that we are a witness to this territory, we'll think it's about church gathering. And on Sunday morning, we dress well and come to church, listen to another sermon, and then we go back. And the moment we are stepping out, we are divided. In the early church, the Bible said there was none among them that lacked. Why was it so? It said those that had possession sold it and brought it to the feet of the apostles, and there was an even distribution. Everybody was carried along. How do you think they could be destroyed? It was not possible. Even though they were chasing them with guns, bows, and arrows, they were invincible. And the point came, the Bible said, the whole city went to them. The whole of Maiduguri can gather here. If the church can master the principle of oneness, if the church can become one, the whole of this city can gather here. Because that was how the apostles did it. And their life is a pattern for all of us. That the only way we can become in the territory is when we become one. Sometimes we pray to God and it looks as if our God is powerless. Sometimes we pray, it looks as if answers are not coming. The answers are already there, but the answers are invested in men. The intervention we are looking for is invested in men already. That was what God taught Paul. Don't look up to me. There is a man called Ananias. That man can raise the greatest apostle. He is in the church. When Paul needed to become popular, in order to preach the gospel of grace, it was not Jesus that met him. It was a man called Barnabas. And Barnabas took Paul to the company of the apostles. And from there, Paul was validated. So from level to level, you discover every solution the church is looking for. There is an individual that embodies that solution. Because we are not ordinary men. We are gates into the heaven of God. And until we begin to discern ourselves and honor ourselves and esteem ourselves over ourselves, we cannot sustain the requisite power and invincibility to take the territory. is why you look at the church today, it reduces to individual giants and individual systems. But if we remain individual giants and individual systems, the enemy will still prevail. The only way we can shift the enemy backward is for us to become one. So one that the enemy will have no access. And this job begins with you. When next you hear somebody made a mistake, don't castigate. Pray for the person. If you have not prayed for a man, you have no right to talk against him. You know, when we come for services, sometimes people want power to move, they want impartation. But our greatest power is resident in our midst. If only we can hold hands together and be one, you will be amazed what we can achieve. And this is why what God wants to do is not to raise superstars, it's to raise an army. And the Bible said, they will not break their ranks. They will not break their ranks. Everything God did for me, He did for me through men. Everything. I had an encounter with Jesus as a young boy, but for many years I was nothing. When I met Pastor Chris Oyakhilome, I honored the grace upon the man, and somehow an oil began to flow through my life. I prayed for the sick, I know I don't have faith, and they are healed. Because I encountered someone. When I met Bishop David Oyedepo, the scriptures came alive. I could quote 50 scriptures in a moment. And then when I look at the scripture, I see what ordinary people don't see. Because that investment is not in heaven, it's in the man called the living. When I met Apostle Arabi Osar, I couldn't go out to preach. Who cares about him? But all of a sudden, people hear one message and it goes viral. And they say, come here, come here, come here. What is happening? I didn't do publicity anywhere. That grace for influence was invested in a man. And as I discerned this man, these things kept through me. I met Andrew Womack and I read his book. And I started following him. And all of a sudden, I saw that the life of God became strong in my spirit. As I'm talking now, if I want the power of God to start moving now, to go now. Now. I don't need to prepare for it. The moment I say it, the energy of God rises in my spirit and it goes forth. How did I encounter it? I touched it from a man called Andrew Womack. He carried so much of eternal life. So much of eternal life was invested in him. Imagine what people carry in the body of Christ that we have not discerned. Even Jesus teaching, he said, be careful to receive men. Because some of them are angels, and some of the men you despise, they are the angels that carry your solution. The Bible said in Genesis 18 that Abraham sat at the door of Mamre and he saw three men. They were walking towards Sodom and he stopped them. He said, sirs, please come in and take water. What does that mean? All of a sudden, barrenness that had been there for many years, men, he saw men. But this man prayed God. And all of a sudden, he looked at him and said, in another time of life, I will visit again, and Sarah, your wife, shall be with child. Abraham had many altars. In Genesis chapter 12 verse 6, Abraham raised an altar in Bethel. In Genesis chapter 12 verse 7, Abraham raised an altar in Ai. In Genesis chapter 13 verse 18, Abraham had altar. Abraham had altars everywhere, but they couldn't cure barrenness. Until he discerned three men. And the men walked up to him. In another time of life, what many altars could not achieve, because Abraham discerned somebody, it was done effortlessly. Even Sarah did not believe, but her unbelief was no longer strong to change the verdict. What is it you have lost because you have refused to discern locality? This is the power of the church. Many people think it's an error to talk about men. They say you are insulting men. Men have met Jesus and he referred them to men. Jesus referred Paul to Ananias. An angel appeared to Cornelius. An angel. And the angel could not do anything. He said, go and look for a man called Peter. Because the whole investment of God is in the church. This is why God sends us to what the world.
Do you think God is insensitive?
God knows that some part of the world they are terrorists. He knows some part of the world there is sickness. How does he still send us to what the world? Because everything we need is with us. We have something that is superior to AK-47. We have something that is superior to HIV/AIDS. It's in the unity of the saints. Because when the saints come together, the glory of God descends. He said the shout of the king is in their midst. There is something we carry. Did you study Israel's life? They were walking from city to city. And he said there was a verdict hanging on their head. He said, touch not my anointed. Do my prophet no harm. Everyone here carries the Holy Ghost and the anointing of God. Why are we done harm? Because we are not one. And when we are not one, we are vulnerable. Your security is not in your wisdom. It's not in the big gate around your house. It's not in your connection to the presidency. It is in the unity of the saints. That's why we must labor and learn to co-inhere with one another. This is the foundation of the authority of the church.